Good evening, everybody. Especially welcome to the students who I think are having the most wonderful learning experience by being involved in this super program. I didn't say my name. I'm Deirdre Dyson. I live at 430 West Loveland Avenue. I have lived in Loveland for approximately 45 years, coming here from England with two young infants and my husband. Probably should have said that the other way around. Sorry, my dear. It wasn't long before I became involved in organizational activities, starting in my local subdivision with the Garden Club. For some reason, I very quickly became president of the Garden Club, which was an all-new and exciting experience for being president of an organization. As you can gather, this was quite a few years ago. Other involvements included the Kiwanis Club, a men's organization, which was very active in staging events and things like that. Was involved in the organization and beginning of Music in the Park program, Christmas in Loveland, was president of the Loveland's Art Council, and invented the current format for the Loveland Art Show. Took it from about 25 exhibitors up to 80, which is the maximum number we could hold in Nesbitt Park. Invented Paint the Town, where we got artists from the tri-state area to just come and paint in Loveland for a week so they could be observed at their craft. Loveland Stage Company found a member, and I was also drama director up at the high school for 10 years. So throughout all of these activities, and any time something went well, I felt tremendous joy and pride in belonging to the community of Loveland. Belonging to an organization, and I probably don't have to tell you young people, you've probably been involved in lots of things. It's just a wonderful way of getting to know people, working for a common goal. So what has happened to all of these activities? A lot of these organizations have defunct or on their last legs. It is becoming harder and harder to stage an event. And most recently, extremely difficult because of changes that the whole thing seems to be in flux. And the reason for that, I don't really know. My mother-in-law, may she rest in peace, she's been deceased for many years now. She had two ways of asking a question. She would say, "What did he do that for?" Or else she would say, "Whatever did he do that for?" And there's a huge difference between those two. So recent changes that have been going on here as regards trying to stage an event, I am at a loss to understand who or whoever and why or why ever somebody thought fit to try and make all these changes. It seems that nobody is benefiting from it. I'm afraid most of City Council is in everybody's bad graces right now. People trying to organize an event are faced with having to come up with background checks on the participants. Imagine having to go to a group of artists and say, "You can't be involved in Paint the Town unless we have a background check on you." Loveland Art Show need a background check on the artists participating in that. It won't happen. It's not going to happen. The event is not going to happen. And it's just another example of things that are getting peeled away as the community loses its sort of signature events. I feel we're all losers. And I don't know yet who is benefiting from these changes. I just put it to you that you give an explanation of the reasoning, and it'll be easier for us to conform with your new rules. So, whatever. let's find out whatever this is all about. Thank you.